So two Polish swimmers, two Ukrainians in this one. A Chilean swimmer, Alberto Abazar. Fastest from the qualification heats this morning. European record held by Sergei Palmarachuk. 3:43.69 set that in the Rio Paralympic Games. And this is the S2 200 freestyle. S1 swimmer Alexei Talai swimming up against the S2s. And this is for the swimmers with the most impairments, so the most impaired swimmers in the Paralympic program, S1 and S2 classes. And you'll see the starts that are employed by a number of the swimmers. Only a couple of differences, but most of the swimmers get held with their feet against the wall to allow them to get up and away into their backstrokes for most of them, with the exception of Alexei Talai, who is on his front.
Yeah, Alexei Talai, the S1 athlete, he swims more of a breaststroke action. He's an athlete with a number of a limb difference, so he's got a very short arm that he uses to propel him through the water, and most other athletes using backstroke so that they can get that full range of motion that they have available to them, there we can see from that wonderful shot, to propel them through the water again as quickly as possible. A range of strokes, and it was Danilenko, the Russian athlete in lane 5, who got off to the best start, but Alberto Abazar of Chile. We saw him finish strongly in the heat this morning, and now he's gone out very quickly too. It's 1:0.28 for Danilenko down that first 50. Abazar just 0.17 behind. And in third place is Roman Badrenko, who's using that double arm backstroke technique. He's just half a second behind Abazar. But there we can see a great shot of three very different backstrokes. Abazar and Danilenko, they look like they're using similar techniques, but they have a very different range of motion and the way that their limbs function. And we can see Abazar there with that flat head, that black cap for Chile, starting to pull away from Danilenko as we come down to the midway point of this race.
Yeah, Abazar swimming it slightly differently than he did this morning. He came through in the second half of the race to qualify fastest for this final, but he's gone out a lot faster in the final tonight. Abazar's going to go over at the halfway point, 2:04.43, followed by Danilenko, 4 seconds behind for Danilenko, and Bondarenko just a couple of seconds behind the Russian. So the Ukrainian a couple of seconds behind the Russian. So Abazar is from out with Europe, so the European top three still up for grabs, and in fourth place, third European, is Jacek Czech of Poland, that time of 2:20.34 at the halfway point. But it's very close between three swimmers for that third European spot. It's all getting a little bit stretched out now as they come to this final turn. Abazar and Danilenko just stretching away from Bondarenko. Abazar really looking good, really powerful Chilean swimmer as he comes into this final turn here. We knew he was strong in the closing stages this morning. He's been strong all the way through tonight. Looks like a great time in prospect here for Alberto Abazar, Liz.
Yeah, Abazar, in the heat, he swam a controlled first 100 and he really built through the second part of the race, but here tonight, he's really gone from it from the start, and he's maintaining that pace very well. You can see that high stroke rate that he uses to get his arms over. You can see where his hands enter the water, that he's not able to get that full range of motion. and then he just catches the water really quickly, so he ensures there's not much of a pause at all in his stroke, and he continues with that forward momentum. And he's looking really, really good as we come down his final stages of the race. And then no one's going to catch him now. Danilenko still going very well for that European title.
Yeah, here is Arbarsa coming into the closing stages. He's going to be just over the 4:15 mark, I think. Yeah, 4:16.17. He will take the European Open title. That's the fastest time in the world this year, improving his own mark that he set in the USA last month. It's going to be a European title for Vladimir Danilenko of Russia. 4:31.33 for Danilenko. It looks like Bondarenko is just going to hold on for second position, second European home. He just does that ahead of Aristidis Makrodimitris. But it will be Makrodimitris will claim the European bronze medal. Bondarenko, the European silver. And Danilenko will be the European champion. But good tussle there between Jacek Cech and Makrodimitris in the lane 6 and 7. That pulled them through very close to Bondarenko up there in lane number 3. But no doubt about the winner for that one. There's a dominant performance there.
Yeah, Batza looks strong, but Makrodimitris, he just got stronger and stronger as the race got on. We're just seeing pictures there of Alexei Talai, the S1 athlete, coming into the final stages of his race. We can see now he's doing a breaststroke stroke. Obviously, it's freestyle, so you can choose to swim whatever stroke you want in a freestyle event, as long as you maintain the same stroke for the entire 50 meters. So we saw him on the first 50 doing more of a front crawl action, and now he's doing breaststroke as he comes into these final few meters. But as I was saying, Makrodimitris, he just got stronger and stronger. At one point, he was sixth in that race at the halfway turn, and he came through to finish very strongly to get that European medal just ahead of Jacek Cech.
There's the final swimmer to complete the distance. That's Julius Trokimczuk from Poland. He swam 6:28 in the heats this morning. He swam 6:28 again tonight. 6:28.80 this morning. 6:28.84 tonight. So that's consistency for you.
Mr. He gets the medal for consistency for sure.
It was the start there. Arbarsar was just extending his lead as the race went on. Danilenko was clear in second place, clearly the first European. And here at the finish, what a finish, as you said, Liz, by Makrodimitris, really coming on strong. Down there in lane number 7, the golden silver medalist in the open event. Well, I should say the open champion and the European champion. Let's say that. Having a chat at the end of the race. They're all rivals. They know each other very well. I'm sure they've competed against each other on the world stage. And tonight it was Alberto Arbarsar who got the better of Vladimir Danilenko. Still waiting for confirmation of the result. It's always a nervous wait, isn't it, Liz, when the result doesn't appear immediately?
Yes, it is. And as we said before, on freestyle events, there are less things that you can be disqualified for, but they're normally more technical things. So your suit might not be appropriate, or you might have the wrong logo on your hat, or you might have a marking or things like that. So sometimes it's a technicality, but obviously we are all hoping for no disqualifications here today. But the lower down the classification system, athletes often have more exemptions to make sure that the way that they've performed whatever stroke it is they're swimming is legal in para swimming terms, and often that can be what leads to a bit of a delay.
Oh well, I think the appearing on our screens, we do have not one but two disqualifications. We'll just wait for confirmation of that, And here we have the official result. Well, it is a shock. Two disqualifications there. Trokimczuk from Poland and Vladimir Danilenko have been disqualified. So the man that we were crowning as European champion has been disqualified there. Alberto Abarza does take the race. He'll be the open champion. But the European champion will be Roman Bondarenko. European silver to Aristidis Makrodimitris and the European bronze to Jacek Czech of Poland. Wow, like a good relay, don't we, Liz? And that was a good one.
Yes, we love the relays, I think. Like we said, so much excitement, potential for drama. Nobody really likes drama. I feel like we've had enough of that tonight. But it's always a really good way to finish. And I think when the crowds are able to be in the venues as well, it just really, really brings them to life.
Yeah, great way to finish for the Ukrainian team. They've had a few good results tonight. They were top of the medal table, equal with the Italians last night. Liz Johnson's furiously working out the position for tonight.
Oh, am I? Yeah, I am, yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Well, those relays are the last swimming action that we will see for tonight's programme. It's absolutely flown by. Probably because we've been in a panic most of the nights, because the technology's failed us early on. But there's Jacek Czech for Poland, claiming another medal. Fantastic swim from him. He's delighted to be on the medal podium again. Fast finishing, Aristidis Makrodimitris getting the silver medal. Well, there is the new European champion, Roman Bondarenko from Ukraine, claiming that gold medal. The 200 freestyle for S2 was won, of course, by Alberto Abarza from Chile. Take the European Open title. And the disqualification of Vladimir Danilenko. Well, that left the way clear for Roman Bondarenko to claim that medal for Ukraine, the gold medal.